Members' motions. Proposed resolution under Article 75 of the Basic Law to amend the rules of procedure. Members who wish to speak, please press the request to speak button. And I'll call upon Mr. Paul TSE to speak and move the motion. Mr. Paul TSE. Thank you, Madam Deputy. As the Chairman of the Committee on Rules of Procedure, CROP, I move that the motion as printed on the agenda be passed to amend certain rules of the Rules of Procedure of the Legislative Council of the Hong Kong Special Administrative Region, ROP. Since the commencement of the 2020-21 session, CROP has been examining the many proposals put forward by members to amend the ROP and House Rules, HR. Apart from some proposed amendments that require further study, CROP decided to take forward the remaining proposals and conducted free consultations exercises. This is to the amendments are to ensure there is efficient conduct of business and also a balance strike with this and the protecting the right of speech of members. As I mentioned, a free consultations exercise were conducted. The proposals were supported by an overwhelming majority of members. The proposals are divided into age groups, five of which involve amending the reference rules of ROP. Proposal 1, to specify that if the President of the Legislative Council, the President, considers the sanction under ROP 45 bracket 2 inadequate in dealing with the grossly disorderly conduct committed by a member in Council, a committee of the whole Council, the Finance Committee or House Committee HC in a single instance or multiple instances, the President may name the member. A motion will then be moved by the President's Deputy for the Council to decide without debate or amendment whether the member should be suspended from the service of the Legislative Council, LegCo. If the motion is carried, the member shall be prohibited from participating in all business of the Council, including all meetings and the handling of complaints, for the period specified in the motion. The remuneration during that period would be withheld on a pro rata basis subject to the relevant legislative amendments. While most members did not support putting in place an appeal or objection procedure, this would not preclude the President from exercising his powers and discretion under the Basic Law BL, the laws of Hong Kong and ROP to ensure that the relevant proceedings comply with the principles of procedural fairness and the rules of natural justice. Proposal 2, to specify under ROP time limits on debates on various types of motions in Council and a speaking time limit for members in the debates. The President, as in the past, may exercise his discretion to specify time limits for individual government bills and members' bills. Proposal 3, to specify under ROP the powers of the committee chairman in office to deal with normal business prior to the election of the committee chairman for a new session, including deciding on the date and agenda of meetings. Proposal 4, to fine-tune the procedure for the adjournment of debate in the Council and specify that ROP 40 bracket 1 would not apply to debates on certain motions. Amendments with substantially the same terms as ROP 40 bracket 4 are also to be made to ROP 40 bracket 1. Proposal 5, to amend certain rules in ROP to prevent the abuse of procedures and enhance operational efficiency. Madam Deputy, as recommended by CROP, HC has endorsed all proposed amendments at its meeting on the 26th of February this year. If my proposed resolution is passed by the Council, the proposed consequential amendments to the relevant HR rules will be approved by HC this Friday, the 26th of March. The consequential amendments will come into effect immediately upon approval. Madam Deputy, so I gave a report on the work of the CROP. Now I'd like to speak in my personal capacity. I'm glad that in this term of the Council, we're able to make major amendments. This is the second time we're doing it. Now, these amendments are not to limit members' constitutional rights and powers, but rather we want to strike a balance between operational efficiency and protecting members' constitutional rights and obligations. So we are just trying to put things right so we could resume normal business. Now, some have questioned certain aspects of our amendments, and the media have expressed concern on certain things too. I will speak on those. Firstly, now it seems that there is less opposition, or there are less trouble stirred up in this council. So how come we need to make these amendments? Well, I would say this is just to make amends. The amendments are not to target individual members, political parties, or anybody's. But rather, we just want to make sure that we could maintain the dignity of this council in the conduct of our business. I'm sure you know what it means by contempt of court, but you know, for the court system and the legislative council system, these are the two pillars in the administering Hong Kong, and then we have seen contempt of the council too, on top of contempt of court cases. So it's about maintaining the dignity of this council. It is necessary that we make these amendments. We are familiar with what it's about when we talk about contempt of court. How come we don't attach equal importance to contempt of this council? That's why we're making these amendments this time. Hopefully we could put things right. Here, I would like to thank members who have made suggestions to amend the rules of procedure and house rules. That includes Mr. Tommy Chung, Dr. Low Wai Kwok, Mr. Gary Chan, and Mr. Horace Chang. They've put forward many useful views on the amendments. And there are many other members who have responded to, actively to our consultation exercises. And they've also expressed support for the amendments. So I would like to thank the Secretariat again, because the clerks and the legal advisors of the Secretariat have done much to make these amendments possible. I don't have much time, but perhaps I will briefly talk about the more important amendments this time round. Now, I mentioned five areas, but I would like to highlight a few amendments. One is about naming members. This is nothing new, actually. As you know, the president or the chairman of committees have the powers to sanction members on the spot if they have you know, misbehaved grossly. But there are just two extremes. Either we evict them and then nothing more happened. And some members might like that, so they go out to, have a smoke or even have some wine or whatever. And then the other kind of sanction is to go by the basic law and remove a sanction motion to disqualify a member. These are two extremes. On one end, the sanction is too lenient. On the other end, the sanction is too harsh. So for many years, people have been wondering if there's a middle-of-the-road approach. So in a case of grossly disorderly conduct, there could be suitable sanction that serves a deterrent effect. So this is what we try to achieve with this round of amendments. We have actually referred to the practices in many countries. And in particular, we've referred to the practice in the UK Parliament because we're familiar with the UK Parliament. I'm sure if you watch soccer games, you know what is the red card and what is the yellow card. Now, even if you are barred from a game, that's not the end of the story. There are other consequences. So here we're talking about suspension for 1 week, 2 weeks, 4 weeks, and so on. And in any case, our practice would be more lenient than that for the UK Parliament. Anyway, I'm not going to go into the details. I'm just saying we have a rigorous process to do that, and not all committees will have this sanction arrangement. It's only at the council, the finance committee, house committee, and committee of the whole council would there be this sanction for the president to name a member who's misbehaved grossly. And then we need to vote on that before this suspension takes effect. And I'm and then the president definitely will follow procedural fairness principles and the rules of natural justice in giving out this sanction. So I believe there is sufficient check and balance. And another issue is about the speaking time limit. That's something of interest to the media too. If you look around other parliaments in common law jurisdictions, that is the UK, Australia, Canada, the US, in fact, in New Zealand too. And in fact, for most parliaments, they are inclined to have a time limit on speech. It's not to limit the rights of members, rather it's about striking the right balance. So it's about the you know, the whole duration for the debate or the speaking time limits of members, that they will set such limits in advance. And now we have we're going for 5 minutes as the speaking time limit for motion debates. This is actually the speaking time limit in the UK Parliament. We understand that for 50% of their motions, they keep to this time limit. So there is no need to be concerned that we are overly limiting members' right to speak. Now, where is appropriate, the House Committee or the President may make a discretion to adjust the speaking time limit. So there is this added protection there. The third amendment. Now, I'm sure you all remember that for 7 months we were not able to elect the chair of the House Committee. So now this the amendment is that before a new chairman is elected, the chairman in office has the power to deal with the business of the committee. Now I'm running out of time. You know other preventing other abuses. I won't go into details, but if there's a chance, I will speak in reply to members' views. And there are two other matters we would like to deal with in the remainder of the term. I'd like to talk about that briefly. One is about the quorum. The basic law has dictated the minimum quorum, but what should happen if there is not a quorum? Now, in the past, we have the quorum calls. This is just arrangement under the rules of procedure. It's definitely not under the basic law. So we just want to make sure that we won't waste time on quorum calls. But how do we do it? Well, that's something we need to study further. Maybe we have to seek legal advice on that, just to be prudent. Another matter is about members who have misbehaved and who have been ordered to leave the meeting. Now, would there be economic or financial sanction? We have to look into that. Maybe there is need for to amend relevant legislation before it can be done, so we have to study that further. Here, I would like to thank the members and clerks again for their assistance. Thank you.
And now I propose a question to the Honourable Paul Chair's motion be passed. Dr. Lo Wai Kwok, we're now scrutinizing the proposed resolution under Article 45 Basic Law to amend the rules of procedure. Well, the filibustering has become the new normal of this chamber. Since 2013, around April and May each year, the legislature will need to conduct a filibustering battle for more than a month on the appropriations bill. Members would move hundreds of thousands of amendments to the appropriation bill. And the president, according to the rule of procedure 96 and the 75 of basic law, we need to set a time limit on the debate, which is called putting a time limit. Take the 2020 appropriation bill, 20 members raising about 124 amendments, about 52 amendments were allowed to move. And the president have allotted 36 hours for the equipment and only complete the third reading on the May 15. Filibustering have not only targeted individual subject matter, but become a year-round phenomenon, objecting everything, and now have run to the Finance Committee and the PWSC, as well as the Establishment Subcommittee, as well as other panels. The Public Works application scrutiny were severely delayed by the filibustering. Some opposition camp members resort to every single tactic and simply commit grossly and orderly conduct, abusing all kinds of procedures to lead to advocating mutual destruction, and even led to bodily confrontation, throwing a pungent liquid in order to obstruct a normal council business and undermining the government. This severely undermined the overall interest of the Hong Kong society, also affecting our livelihood. There were calls in society urging to council to review the ROP for an orderly and efficient transacted business by Legico. The amendment of the ROP is not the first time. The most recent one occurred in 2013 November, to December, which achieved three results. First, the quorum call were more flexible to reduce the chance of abortion. Committee of the whole council reduced from 35 to 20. And any time before the next meeting, also convene any meeting, which enhanced the powers of the president and allowed the discretion to combine or modify amendments or to produce prevents. If the president sees that some of the bills witness and abusive procedures, they were not allowed to move the motion or were put to vote without debate. The operations of Mr. Chamber will become briefly smooth and to not stop the opposition members abusing other procedures. In 2019, on the amendment to the extradition bill, which led to social unrest, not only led to severe vandalism of this legislature and also led to advocacy of mutual destruction clouding the Hong Kong and the legislation. And in the beginning of the 2019 term, there was a severe delay in the election of the House Committee chairperson. Based on local circumstances, the House Committee chairman election will be concluded in one sitting. And on the October 15th to the May 8th of 2020, the House Committee have organized a sit for 17 meetings and yet failed to elect a new chairperson. At the meetings presided by Dennis Kwok have not been upholding our OP election rules, allowing the members to raise questions unrelated to election and unlimited and unrelated questioning, and also move raising multiple points of order, wasting valuable meeting time. After 7 months of impasse and failed to yet elect a chairman, this was unprecedented and also led to a social outcry. As the new chairman has been actually delayed, the House Committee had not been able to deal with this business. For example, the 14 bills and over 90 pieces of subsidiary legislation tabled by the government, and also the appointments of senior judicial officers. And the president, while seeking external outside opinion, I decided, based on ROP 92, to exercise your power, stipulating that Mr. Chan Kin Po, in year 2020, May 18th meeting, to preside over the election. The establishment camp and also stemmed all the interference and disruption and elected Mr. Star Lee as the chairman of the House Committee, who put an end of this chaos. After this, we now understand that the ROP would start as a gentleman's agreement. However, if the provisions were too lax, that would be manipulated by those with ulterior motives. As such, there will be strong views in the public urging the Legico to modify the ROP as soon as possible, besides asking to block all kinds of loopholes and also on members' grossly misbehave and also set a penalty for members. And this round of members actively respond to the calls of the society. In the 2020 to 2022 year term of Legico, the committee of ROP have been looking into the various recommendations on the ROP and the health rules. As a member of the CROP, and on January 15, have written to Mr. Paul Chair, on splitting a time limit for electric crew in deal with all kinds of motions on January 29th. Once again, written to Chairman Chair for further views. And for the number of time and also the speak limit, I also offer more detailed proposals for the consideration of the CROP. The CROP considered the views of my proposed amendments by myself and other members, widely accompanying this multiple provisions on ROP and house rules. On November and February, the last year and this year, the CRP have reached the significant views of the whole chamber. And the first batch of proposals with majority support now been tabled to House Committee. On 26th of February, the House Committee have endorsed the first batch of amendments on this CROP. The approach, according to Basic Law Article 75, have moved this resolution and also amended the provisions in the ROP. Upon this passage, and the various amendments and the House rules will be tabled to be approved by the House Committee. This proposed resolution mainly covers the first special amendments on the rule of procedures and House rule, including five proposals. First, on the sanction against grossly disorderly conduct of members, and also without the new provision of 45 bracket A of naming members. Stipulated members, if any grossly misconduct in the House Committee Council and under 45 bracket 2, what is about, and well, there is any shortcomings to the electoral president, at any time he deems suitable, can name such a member. The deputy will then move a motion without any debate or amendment to whether the member should be suspended from the service of electoral for the period specified in the motion. The duration of the suspension is subject on the escalating scale of severity. If the motion is carried, the member suspended will be prohibited from participating in office of the council. And also subject to making necessary amendments to relevant legislation, a financial penalty will be imposed for the period of suspension on a prorated basis. The second proposal, mainly about related to my proposed amendments, to amend the speaking time limit on the provision Section 37. On substantive motions, the ROP 18 bracket 1 I to N, on the items mentioned under which, and procedure motions, which are procedural in nature and related to regulation of council proceedings in council. And also a speaking time limit for individual members in each debate with respect to different types of motions. Legislative president can discretion to adjust that limit. This proposal helped to strike a balance and while encouraging members to speak succinctly and enhancing the council efficiency. At the same time, hopefully, the legislature can duly discharge its constitutional duty. The third proposal have a new section 75D. The powers of the committee chairman in office to deal with the normal business prior to the election of the committee chairman for a new session. Explicitly provided that the term until the election of the next session is elected, and the chairman and deputy chairman in office shall have all the powers may be exercised by chairman or deputy until his or term office ends, either upon the commencement of the next session or the election of the chairman of the next session, whichever the later. The effect is plain to see. It does stop a repeat of the election impasse of the House Committee Chairman. The fourth proposal will be fine-tuning the procedure for adjournment of debate in new council under creating a new ROP 46A. And if the President deemed that the adjournment motion as abuse of procedures, they will not allow the motion to move or will put this motion to a vote without debate. the powers of the president will be more expressly provided in the fifth proposal and on proposed amendments to prevent possible abuse of procedures, which including amending RP 63, that during the third reading debate, that should all that only speak succinctly on whether they support this bill. They cannot debate the overall merits and the principles as well as the proposed amendments or independent provisions. And these matters have already been covered in the second reading. And this is simply all the advice and the rule of, instead of being an unwritten rule, have now enshrined in the RLP. The five proposals on the amendment to RLP will simply put a more stringent requirement and simply complement the shortcomings of the existing provision and also have more express provision on the present discretion. In order to put the electoral put on the right track and to avoid a repeat of a disheartening chaos, I personally believe the amendment to the RLP will not be the last time. And we need to act with the times. If official council business still expose other problems at RLP or we come into new scenarios, a further enhancement to the RLP for more efficient discharge of the council's constitutional duty under the basic law was simply the right thing to this duty to do so. President, I so submit a supporting Mr. Paul Chia's motion.
Mr. Ronick Chen. President, the Legislative Council is the legislative body of the Hong Kong SAR. We have the responsibility to comply with the basic law in legislation and repealing laws, and also approving the budget and estimates, receive policy address from the CE, and also question the government on its work, and also debate on matters of public interest. It is specified under the basic law the power enjoyed by the Legislative Council, the President, and Council members. However, it does not specify how these powers should be exercised. Article 75 of the Basic Law confers the power of setting its own rules by the Legislative Council for cases when there is no conflict between the rules and the Basic Law. The court usually upheld the Legislative Council's power. Since the 2nd of July 1998, we have adopted the rules of procedures of the Legislative Council as the blueprint of the RLP. After all, the RLP was regularly amended as per our practice. However, the RLP is not exhaustive. It cannot include all kinds of scenarios. We rely on the mutual respect and understanding among members. That is the gentleman's agreement. However, when there are people with ulterior motives abusing the rules, it will be catastrophic. The Legislative Council was established in 1843 with the governor and three officials. The governor would be the president of the Legislative Council. The two non-official members were appointed in 1850. 30 years later, in 1880, we had the first Chinese non-official member. The number of council members have increased in time. In 1985, the number of Legislative Council members have increased to 57. The first term of Legislature of the handover was 60. In 2015, the number increased to 70. According to the decision approved by the NBCSC, for the next Legislative Council term, the number of seats will increase to 90. It will be 22.5 times more than the number in 1843. Because of the increasing number of seats, we have to set a limit on the time of debates to ensure efficient operation. if there's not enough time for members, if there is unlimited time for members to debate unlimitedly, it will jeopardize the efficiency. The UK Parliament has amended its RP to set limits on debates in council and sets a maximum of 10 minutes for debate time, including second reading debate of government bills. When we talk about second reading debate, we still remember the 2016 amendments bill for registration ordinance of medical offices. The debate went on and on because of the endless filibustering of the pro-democracy members. The bill was void. The opposition can deliberately use filibustering tactics like moving motions for the adjournments of council to oppose the government. In 2012, some members submitted a total of 1,306 amendments with 1,000 pages thick to filibuster the process. The members made calls for quorum counts repeatedly and also filibustered the meetings by moving motions. The then president exercised his power under the RP to adjourn the debate and ended the debate, which went on for 100 hours and 23 minutes. In the past legislative term, there were people abusing the process, the procedures, and delay the return of the chairperson of the House Committee for 7 months and paralyzing the House Committee. A lot of bills were not able to be deliberated. In the first meeting of this legislative session, when we resumed second reading debate of the government's bills, which were not handled in the previous session, the mutual destructive party members filibustered the meeting as well. They have twisted the spirit of the rules and jeopardized the governance of the Hong Kong SAR government and weakened our competitiveness, undermining our economic development and livelihood of people. President, I am also a member of the CROP. I thank Dr. Lo Wai Kwok, Mr. Gary Chan, and also Tommy Cheng for moving amendments to amend the RP. After 3 rounds of discussion, we support the amendments moved by the 3 members. The amendments can be separated into several parts. First, sanctions against grossly disorderly conduct of members. In the past, there were members who often disrupts the order of meetings. However, the Legislative Council did not stop them. That's why these antics are repeated. Like the UK Parliament, for members who have committed grossly disorderly conduct in a single instance or multiple instances, the President may name the member and suspend the duty of the member, and also withhold the salary according to the suspension time. And also, the second part is about specifying time limits on debates in council and adjusting the length of members' speeches. For members' motion and government's motion, the speaking time will be reduced to 10 minutes by 15 minutes. For second reading, the speaking time will be reduced as well, and also a time limit of 4 hours is set. Overseas parliaments have also set limits, time limits on debate time because of the increasing number of seats. This is in line with the global trend. We should focus on the quality rather than the length of our speeches. That's why shortening the time of our allowed for our speech will not jeopardize the quality. Another proposal is about fine-tuning the procedure for the It's about the powers of the committee of the chairman in office to deal with the normal business prior to the election of new chairman. Proposal 4 is about fine-tuning the procedure for the adjournment of debates in the council. The above two proposals are to prevent abuse of the procedures. President, with the national security law as well as the quit en masse of the opposition camp, order has returned. However, we should learn from the past experience to plug the loopholes and make preparations for every scenario, as well as make necessary amendments to the ROP to avoid chaos in the council so that we can function orderly and also ensure the successful implementation of one country, two systems. This is our duty and also the Legislative Council's duty. That's why I support the resolution moved by the CROP. Thank you.
Mr. Tony Chair. Thank you, President. The culture, order, and quality of work, as well as the efficiency of our work in of this council has declined over the past decade. Things became worse and worse. Now, we had the opposition camp and the Burn With Us camp. In the past few years, there's no more rule and order to speak of in this council. It's seriously undermined the development of our economy and people's livelihood. Now, at the beginning, they started with with rude language, and then they insulted government officials, and then they started to swear, and then they promoted hatred. I don't think any parliaments in the world would condone or tolerate such behavior. And then later on, they started hurling bananas, water glasses, and so on. And then recent years, they started snatching the microphone documents, mobile phones, and they threw, foul smell materials and so on. And then they also injured security officers. So honorable members became rioters who broke the law. They were just terrorists. And then on filibustering, at the beginning, they filibustered because they were opposed to a certain bill or motion, but eventually they filibustered for no reason. They were just resorting to such means to try to drag things on. Now, of course, the most striking case was the show staged by the former legislator, Mr. Dennis Kwok, who filibustered for 7 months so we couldn't elect the chairman of the House Committee. The function of legislature to scrutinize bills became reduced to nothing. So we were not, bills were not were considered. And then they when they made affirmation, they took the opportunity to promote independence of Hong Kong, and then they even backed foreign forces to sanction Hong Kong and the mainland. They wanted to bring down all 7 million people of Hong Kong together with them. They wanted to harm the economy of the mainland. So these people don't really qualify to become legislators. In fact, they shouldn't even be considered Chinese. Now, there are various loopholes in the in our law. So, in the past year or two, the Central People's Government has taken resolute actions to put things right. This is to ensure the long-term stability and prosperity of Hong Kong, and this is to make sure that one country, two systems could be implemented in the long run. Now, the CPG first enacted the national security law, and then there was the interpretation of the qualification of legislators, And then recently, the MPC just passed the decision to improve the electoral system of the Hong Kong SAR. So for all these MPC interpretations and MPC decisions, they've helped to resolve the problems faced by Hong Kong caused by the black shirt riots and so on. So they have tackled the source of the problem by improving the electoral system. So this is to make sure that patriots administering Hong Kong could be given full implementation. Of course, I will support such actions. I will support the legislative exercise to be carried out. But then for other misbehavior that's not yet against the Constitution, the MPC interpretation may not be able to deal with such matter. In fact, we shouldn't ask the CPG to handle such matters. Those who want to build Hong Kong in this council should be able to handle such matters. So the chairman of the Committee on Rules of Procedure, Mr. Paul Chair, has moved this resolution today. This is exactly to put things right after all that chaos in this council. We want to plug the loopholes in the rules of procedure, because we need to improve the governance efficiency of the SAR. This is what the NPC asked of us in this decision on the 11th of March. So I fully support such a reforms. Now, there are 18 amendments that cover various details that will help to prevent members from abusing the procedure. For example, moving indiscriminately, adjourning debates and using other means to filibuster. And also on the debate duration and speaking time limits, there will be limits set too. So I'm grateful to members of CROP and the colleagues of the Legislative Secretary for the hard work they've put into preparing these amendments. Now, Amendment 10 probably is the most talked about. That is the suspension arrangement. Now, for members who have been ruled to have committed grossly disorderly conduct, if they disregard advice and reminders made by the President may may take action to suspend such members from the council business for some time. This is to prevent them from keep disrupting our proceedings. Now, this is nothing new, really. Many other parliaments do something similar. So I hope the CROP will consider further whether we could deduct remuneration from members who've been suspended. We have to suspend their remuneration and other allowances that would serve the strongest deterrent effect. And also amending Rule 16, that is, if committee could not elect a new chairman for the new session, then the chairman in office could continue to deal with normal business prior to the election of the new chairman. This is to make sure that the committees could continue to function normally. This is to address this farce of the House Committee Chairman election. That is what we call the Dennis Kwok incident. I've actually written 4 or 5 articles to criticize Dennis Kwok. So therefore, I will fully support this new amendment. Now, finally, I'd like to speak on shortening the speaking time limit of members. And I've actually expressed my views during the CROP discussion. Now, the speaking time limit of members would be substantially reduced, say from 7 minutes to 4 minutes, or from 15 minutes to 5 minutes. I have a reservation about that, because there are probably bills that are complicated and technical. They may have far-reaching impact on the relevant profession. So a speaking time of 5 minutes would be too short. Of course, the MPC has decided that the council would be membership would be expanded to 90 members. So if each speaks 5 minutes, then it would take an hour and a half to finish the debate. But we could limit the debate duration in addressing that issue. Now, the reference rule will be amended, so the chairman could, the committee could make a recommendation to the president, and the president also has the power to adjust the speaking time limit of members. I hope the House Committee will make such recommendations in the future as necessary, and also when the president exercises his powers, I hope he will have regard to my views. Now, I'm sure many electrical members have this experience. Now, after the Burn With Us camp has been signed en masse, members have now a heavier workload, and voters in the country have also high expectation of us. Now, we are going to amend the rules of procedure. And then later on, there will be local legislative exercise to improve the electoral system. So people probably will have even higher expectation. I hope members will all work harder so we could participate actively in the work of this council. We must play a better role in monitoring the work of the government. Where credit is due, we should give credit, and where criticism is due, we should make criticism. We want to show the people that we have quality and efficient conduct of business here. Thank you.
Mr. Tommy Cheng. Thank you, President. I speak to support the proposed resolution under Article 45 of the Basic Law to amend the Rules of Procedure. There are a few highlights in this round of amendments, as a few colleagues before me have spoken about on the history, that how we arrived today on these amendments. Especially, I would like to touch on the 45A on the naming of members as well. 79D on the suspension of members from electrical service, and also the power of the committee chairman and to deal with no business prior to the election of the committee chairman of a new session. Well, we all were saddened by how state of things have become. We mainly imported the ROP from the UK Parliament. When looking at the foreign parliaments, for example, the UK, well, our colleagues are invited, we're invited every year to visit the parliament. Like my colleagues mentioned, their parliaments are more of a gentleman's agreement. The ROP have set up different provisions and also, but not the execution details. We assume that we're all gentlemen and know to do the right thing, when which are definitely taboo. Since a decade ago, the Hong Kong Legco, we're seeing members keep looking for loopholes in the ROP for their maneuvers. They thought they're well-versed in the ROP. However, by exploiting this loophole, they are undermining the Legco order. They are putting on a show at Legco and see at theater. I most detest them for objecting everything for the government in him to undermine the governance, even for sound policy disregarding public livelihood. This is anything but gentlemen. I would treat them and see them as thugs. Back then, I didn't understand how could the public condone this with their votes. I was also baffled what turned out to be a good thing, what was started out a good thing, or some policy decided to go against the government and object this good policies and good governance. I understood for the past 2 years, well, revolution tend to breed in very tough times. to which require bad times to film them. If everyone is prosperous, it's very hard to incite a revolution. The public should notice this acts of these people. Our colleagues who described 2019 the black card violence as the peak of political chaos. I've been a legislative member for 21 years. I saw it myself that the 2012 anti-national education seed that the fall started to fall from grace, would start to try to attempt to overturn all the good policies in order to let to poor let to bad governance. I saw members object to the OH limits and keep on moving 37A motions, thousands of those, not hundreds. Back then, I need to estimate how much time I need to deal with each motion. They will usually be done on average over one per minute. This kind of filibustering, if we let a delay of 2 months of receiving the old age allowance, most of the colleagues were supportive of this measure. I forgot what was the voting record. The other pandemics seems to be shouting from the other side of the river while seeing the burning buildings on the other side, while their own constituents were suffering, but did they actually care? My colleagues mentioned the reform on the Medical Council of Hong Kong. I will not go dwell into the specifics. I also would like to remind the public who are listening in, well, what were the reform proposals about? The 24 council members, the 4 layman representatives, well, we add 4 more of them to expand it to 28. So the medical representatives still accounted for 20 versus 8. The doctors haven't lost their majority in the MCHK. And there were some instances that even the judges wouldn't agree with this. Well, it seems that the doctor in question, well, with actually some kind of cozy atmosphere among the prosecution and council members and the defendants. And the patients would take 8 years or 10 years to get justice. That's why I moved a private member's bill. I didn't want to start anything. I just wanted to make the family members of the patients to let them know that whether the doctors are guilty of misconduct. I just want to help them get the truth instead of waiting for 8 years or a decade. As my colleague before me said, this bill would force to start over at the next session. The public should see it for themselves. Some members, or former ones, who are a doctor themselves, that never declared the interest that as a doctor, that's why they went on the filibustering. They just claimed themselves as a member elect from the anti-West geographic constituency. Such practice, and also when Lechko were having such members, how should we put it back on the right track? From 2019 Black Card riots, must be the lightning rod for the amendment, and also with collusion with the pandemics, and also there are setting a fire outside everywhere all over Hong Kong. Our memory was still fresh when
the House Committee took about 7 months to elect a new chairman, and someone throwing a stink bomb in the council chamber and charging onto the president's podium, which led to the paralysis of the legislature, and Hong Kong couldn't move forward. So Liberal Party and I are very supportive of naming grossly disorderly members and also suspend them from duty, which will have a deterrent effect. We cannot allow a small band of troublemakers to paralyze electrical business and also get in the way of government pro-life policies. We cannot afford to diddle or support to stop members to stop electrical business by delaying the election of the chairman. This one amendment simply aims to fix the past mistake of the RP Liberals to prevent members who aim to prevent loopholes from breaking laws. That's why I support this resolution based on Article 75 of Basic Law to amend the rules of procedure to make everything explicit, ensure that council operation is smooth. And finally, well, I forgot how many years I've set in the committee on the rules of procedures. No matter who is the president, that's Paul Che and also Mr. Tam Yu Chung, and always ask the secretary to do some study report. I always advise them against doing so. Fortunately, well, they still go ahead despite my advice. I would say that the past study by the clerks and the Radio Service Division have not gone wasted. And we have devoted so much time in fixing the ROP. It's all due to the hard work in the past. You know that this report may not lead to anything. You proceed anyway. And we are ably final to put this resolution ROP to let you go. I would like to thank the Research Division. The meeting will be adjourned and returned by 9 a.m. tomorrow morning.